We're starting the second weekend of the first record of any video carving that I do. And we're starting out with a spoon, as you are well aware from last weekend. I'd like to make something clear. We're in the month of August, not September. As I indicated last weekend. And when you take those dates and apply them to Friday and Saturday, they won't work for September. They'll only work for August. Okay. We will be presenting material on the 16th. And the 17th, Friday the 16th and the 17th of August. Every once in a while, I'm going to give you a little background of my family, because I think it plays a very important part in how I turned out to be a person. Even though I don't have any other relatives that are anywhere in the same dilemma or cultural makeup that I am. Even my sibling, my sister, we're hardly even close to how we perceive the world around us. But regardless of what other members of the family, cousins and so on, are doing, my major strengths and my major development stem from my grandmother on my mother's side, my mother, and my dad. Those were my basic parents. And my mother and father, they did not lean on grandmother, so they were the stewards, or they were the ones that raised my sister and I. We're going to talk about one thing that I do, and that is I was instilled with a sense of independence. I was instilled with a sense of self-reliance to the point that I refuse, in many cases, any assistance or help from somebody outside the family. Okay, that's a little hard to understand where I'm coming from. By the time I was 80 years old, I had my first business of selling fruits and vegetables. I noticed my dad, when he would go out painting on the landscape, he carried a little lunch bag with him. I did the same. I didn't spend one dime, one cent. Even though I passed stores on the way, I carried my little lunch bag. And if I needed something to drink, I also had that. Each time I went out, I would open the refrigerator and hunt things that were accessible to me, what, you know, my mother said was okay. And I took that out, and that's what lasted me the whole day. I'd go out early in the morning, come back in the evening, not eating or drinking anything that somebody else had. That's my choice. You see, we all learn different things from our parents. My dad didn't say, do that. I chose to do that because I saw him doing that. When we became teachers, I saw him taking a slide projector to work, and he had some slides that he had taken with his own camera. When we did African American studies, he employed me, or he let me know that he would like some help in taking pictures of African American artists from books. And I found out that he would be eventually renting slides, that is, on the college would be renting slides from prospective book companies, or they would be sent free to be looked at. I got equipment. I bought equipment. It was in glass or whatever it is, lifted everything that was sent. I didn't steal it. I just took the, what they call it, intellectual properties. That's what I stole. I didn't steal the slides. I didn't steal but this was something a little different than what African Americans were advocating, particularly the far left, some extents, instances of the far right. I was in with the Soul Students, the forerunner of the Black Student Union, but I didn't do things they were doing. I listened to them. I listened to them talk about self-reliance and those things, the Panthers. Even though I wasn't a part of the Panthers, I got information from them. Most of these groups were using grants. The Panthers had means by which they had some things which they used. Bobby was a good at figuring out things that they could do to sell and make money in the very beginning. And then, of course, we know about the Black Panther paper. But nearly all of them, either on the left or on the right, got into grants, subsidies of some sort. I learned from my parents that was unacceptable. We don't, as a family, we don't touch that stuff. It don't belong to us, and we don't have no connections with it. And you get crippled if you touch any of that stuff. Okay, I'll talk more about it later. It was very consistent. It wasn't something that you practice that 1 minute and then you do the same another minute. I will say this much. My dad would get film strips, slides, photographs. He had things coming from other artists. I processed it all. I duplicated as many copies or whatever it is he wanted. I had my own system. I didn't go to some lab and do it. The lab was right there in the family estate, and I used my room and I used the basement to have all that done. So what you're seeing is an extension of that. I believe that you should create your own history, your own concept of where you're going in life, particularly if you have been robbed of that. You don't want somebody else coming. You don't want foreigners coming in and describing your existence, what you said. You want to do that yourself. And if you're fortunate to be with a group, the group puts those ideas and those concept of philosophy in place. Okay, so anything that I'm showing you connected with Africa, I'm the buck stops here. Okay, and So, without any further ado, let's get started with the the second half, the second weekend, and I hope you were able to get something out of it, and just once in a while I'll drop a little hint of myself so you can get some idea. Well, what he's doing just didn't happen. It was an accident. He didn't study under anybody. So how did he get it? My dad was a Western artist. By the fact that I saw somebody doing art, and it didn't have any relationship to Africa, I made the contact. I made the connections. I could see this one. I can compare and figure out how to connect the dots. Okay, that's all for the, what do you call it, 90%, not 90%, 90% knowledge or lesson. This way.
How are you?
Which
one
you
shared
your hand?
What's that?
El.
Oh, okay.
¿Cuánto estaba? 70, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90,
donde allá en la cuna.
Oh.
A ver si voy a hacer.
All right, I'll have my mom.
ahorita va a venir. Voy a dar una vuelta ahorita, ven.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
No wagon,
huh?
No wagon.
Oh.
So you gotta watch it go run this way or that way.
Kind of hard.
Right.
Thank you.
Hello, this is Claude Clark from, Creative Source at earthmetropolis.com. This video will be uploaded on YouTube, and what we've been looking at is the rough carving of a spoon. Okay, we might continue one more weekend, I'm not sure. There have been two Fridays and two Saturdays. If you look at the time on the videos, they comes to about 2 hours, close to 2 hours. I know I said something different in the narration because I have no sense of the time. I don't pay any attention to it. But we have a clock now, and we'll go by that clock. Okay. This is a smoothed out version. The bowl will be the next stage. These bowls are not suitable for spoons. Okay, and it's very important to get the bowl correct. And we may not see that in this video series. You might see a whole series of spoons being bowled or finished up. You can see that we started from this, just a block sculpture from the sawmill, and then we're transforming the sculpture from the sawmill and gradually, little by little, into another sculpture. And here we cut the curve and start cutting the bowl out. And this we start designing a little bit and doing something to the bowl, doing something to this category here. And you can see the curve under there. That doesn't seem like much, but when we get into more complicated things, you'll probably appreciate the spoons. Because we can, anything I can think of, providing it's not in timber, because timber, we have to close it. Anything in lumber or killed that is things that have been set through the kill for a number of years or whatever, we can accomplish that here because I don't have to have space to use oils and solvents and wax, heat wax, to seal it up each time we open it up. And you've seen the space that we work with. Okay, so whatever conditions you find yourself under, if you are trying to develop something, don't let the dimensions or the accommodations stop you from doing what you need to do. Okay. You'd be surprised. Sometimes almost the impossible could be accomplished where you thought that there wasn't any possibilities. Okay. After we see the first, this will be, let's see, we're looking at the part that we'll be looking at now is a Saturday. And I'll get back to you after the Saturday. We just finished the section on Friday. And that would be Friday the 16th. And this is Saturday the 17th, August. Okay. So now working with the ads and the knife. Previous videos, it's been all ads. Now we're getting to the next tool, the ads and the knife. And I don't think we've seen any chisels used. Okay. But if it's easier to use one, you know, you don't hesitate to pick one up and do what you got to do, providing it doesn't it saves time. Okay. So after that, we'll get back to you, and I hope you enjoy presentation. Bring him in there. Put a diaper on the dog.
I I felt somebody there, but I didn't hear the door open. You could feel somebody. Right.
How are you?
How are you? Fine.
Thank you.
I like our favorite
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is a wrap-up of 2 weeks of exploring my first video. And first video is concerning carving spoons. I've done that a bit, but we're talking about actual action. This is my first sweat video. Okay. Two Fridays, two Saturdays. First Friday, the 10th, August 10th. From 10 to about 11:30, deep carving. Saturday, August 11th, from 10:30 to about 11:30. Then sometime in the afternoon, maybe it was around 3, and I don't know when I stopped it. 3. Two sessions on Saturday, one session on Friday. The next weekend, one session on Friday, and one session on Saturday, and both were morning sessions, and the timing was about the same. Okay, up to this point, and probably the next few video sections, they will be solo. You've seen the camera and you see me working with a remote. And added to that is the tripod. So with these three items, I managed to get something down. There's no such word as cat. It's a nasty word. It's vulgar. My grandmother got me to stop that when I was 7 years old. I told her that the word was in a dictionary. She told me, "Don't go get a pair of scissors." And I told her it was in a dictionary and in books. She said, "Well, go get a pair of scissors, cut it out." Okay. I was a little slow, but I wasn't stupid. My parents, my mother and father, had a nostalgia for books. So you imagine me cutting the word camp out of something that they consider the only real source to success, being able to read, being able to gain all this knowledge. So, I got rid of the word. It didn't take me, once grandmother said it, I just got rid of it. But in my mind, I was still thinking it. So it took a little while to get rid of it. A four-letter word, C-A-N apostrophe T. So whatever you do, just put your mind to it. And my advice is stay clear of people that tell you or try to convince you that it's not possible. Just take them off of your list. Okay. Now, one thing I want to get across is we've been talking about single-handed tools. The major one, the first one, is a hoe. It's 45 degree angle, and it's like we use it like a digging stick. Digging stick was used by pre-agricultural people, people who were food gatherers. The women used it. Men used it also looking for, trying to dig holes, get porcupine out, trying to dig fruit that had water in it, dig it out of the ground so they they would have water to drink. Okay. And then later it was used by people, women, who were tilling for, and also men who were getting the soil ready to plant crops. So we have been concerned with the single-handed tools. This is another type of single-handed tool. Okay. This is another form of a single-handed tool. Notice I'm using the term single-handed. I didn't say anything about a heads. I didn't say anything about a medics. Single-handed tool. This hand is free. This hand is free to hold the sculpture that we're dealing with. The knife is in between. We hold the sculpture with one hand, and at the same time, we can assist the knife with the same hand that's holding the sculpture. And sometimes the knife has to work on its own. Okay. This is the bridge between single-handed tools or items. We there's a mallet, there's a chisel, and there's a gouge that is used too, and we will apply those later, but right now I wanted to get you acquainted with just the knife and the different, or some of the, is there others, several different types of single-handed tools. Okay. This brings us to a close on our 2-week presentation. Push the subscribe button. You can make comments and also give us indication whether you liked or didn't like it. And until next time, have a good week, and I'll be in touch with you again. Thank you very much.